I mean, I he's playing for the Mothers.
Okay, great.
Am I doing the bridal party? So, go on.
The bridal party?
No.
So you're just the bride?
Yeah.
Got it.
It's the wedding party, when is she?
Oh, okay, so you're not the bridal party then?
No, he's the Mothers.
Okay, great. So, there will be a door closed. So there's, it starts closed, it opens, Mothers.
Gotcha.
Then, there's like six pairs of grandparents and everything, so like, yeah, you'll probably play the whole thing, honestly. Because the guy's gonna, he's just gonna be a guy lighting candles, and he takes a while.
Yes.
So like, there'll be a guy lighting candles, and then there'll be like, probably six sets. I think is what it was. And then, actually I have a number. What are we guessing? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sets.
Okay.
Yeah. And then those doors will close, and then the
Thank you. Friends, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it, trusting that our love for one another is born out of God's love for us. We gather in joy today to worship God and celebrate the gift of marriage. Please be seated. So welcome all of you to this celebration of life and love. We are gathered here in the presence of God to witness as Chloe Elise Hamilton and Cody Justin Griffith make their vows to live faithfully together in plenty and want, in joy and sorrow, in sickness and in health. We are here to surround them with our support and ask God's blessing upon them, that they would be strengthened for their life together. So before we go any further, let us pray together. O God, you are love, and those who abide in love abide in you, and you in them. You are the one who makes the sun to shine and the rain to fall. You gift us with breath and laughter. You are at work always for justice, and you are ever near to the brokenhearted. With all that you have to do, we are grateful that you have chosen to be here in this place. So make us aware of your presence, we pray. Open our hearts that we would remember these moments and carry them with us, reminding us always just how powerful love can be. In Christ's name we pray, amen. So here is what we in the church believe to be true. That God gives us marriage as a covenant, a binding commitment between two people, and those bound to one another in marriage belong to one another. It is a holy mystery in which two distinct and different people are joined together and become one. Those entering into marriage are called to a new way of life, a way of mutual love and respect, openness and faithfulness. And this way of life must not be entered into carelessly, but with a deep awareness of its sacred and enduring nature. We rejoice that marriage is a gift given today to the two of you. Now, this gift is no small thing. It is the giving of your promises and your truest selves, your strengths and your weaknesses, your hopes and your dreams. So having been reminded that marriage is indeed a gift, and understanding as fully as you can what it means to be joined in life and in love, recognizing that marriage will ask a tremendous amount of you, but also give you more than you could imagine, I invite you to answer these questions of intent. Chloe, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you desire to enter into this covenant with Cody? Do you? And Cody, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you desire to enter into this covenant with Chloe? Do you? Now, what I know about God is that God is always doing something new in the world and something new in our hearts. So today, with your vows, you will create a new family, and we thank God for that. And yet, you both come from your own families who have helped bring you to this point in your lives, and they are here with you today doing what they do, support you. They wouldn't dream of being anywhere else right now. Now, it used to be that at weddings, the bride was given away, but Chloe, your parents raised an independent woman, and you have demonstrated well that you can make your way in this world, and yet from them you have learned what it means to love. And it used to be that at weddings, nothing was asked of the groom's family. It was assumed that a man stood on his own and had no need of any sort of support. But Cody, you stand here today because of your family. Through them, you have learned to stand tall in this world, and they have shown you what it means to love. And so I have a question for your families now, and I invite you to turn and look at them as they answer this question. Chloe and Cody have looked to you. They have looked to you in times that are significant, in times that are mundane, and they have seen in you the face of encouragement and the reality of love. And they look to you now not for permission, but for the same support you have shown them all along. So will you give your blessing to Chloe and Cody, promise to do everything in your power, upholding them in their marriage? Will you? And now to every single one of you gathered in this space, because today you are more than spectators, and you are more than good friends gathered for a great party, although you are that too. You are here right now, gathered as God's congregation, surrounding these two with love and support and witnessing the promises they make. So I ask all of you to make a promise now. Will you encourage Chloe and Cody in their marriage? Will you pray for them and support them, stand with them in sorrow, and celebrate with them in joy? Will you? Those are good and holy words. So too are the words of scripture and prayer that we hear now from some of those who mean the most to this couple.
Ecclesiastes chapter 4. Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one will lift up the other. But woe to one who is alone and falls and does not have another to help. Similarly, if two lie together, they keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? A threefold cord is not quickly broken. Let us pray. Father, we come before you today in humble respect in all of you. You are the one who knows the plans you have for all of us, and you knew before the beginning of time the plans of this day for Cody and Chloe. You are the orchestrator and creator of all, and we praise you for this holy moment. Father, we bless the union of this special couple according to Ephesians 3, that out of your glorious riches, you would strengthen Cody and Chloe with power through your spirit in their inner being, so that Christ may dwell in their hearts through faith. We pray that they, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the Lord's holy people to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, and that they may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. I bless Cody and Chloe with devotion and respect for one another, gentleness and kindness in trying circumstances, patience in difficulty, joy through hardships, and may your love overflow to them through them like rivers of living waters. May your faithfulness be their stronghold. Protect them by the power of the Holy Spirit, and may they be one as you and the Father are one. I also bless the merging of our families who love Cody and Chloe very much. May we be the support they need, loving them, honoring them, praying for them at all times as we honor you. And as your word says, two are better than one. May Cody and Chloe endlessly help one another up in allowing you to be the completer of them in their marriage and the vision of their souls. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Beloved, let us stand and together sing hymn 450 in the purple hymnals, Be Thou My Vision. You may be seated.
A reading from Ruth, chapter 1. Do not press me to leave you, to turn back from following you. Where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there will I be buried. May the Lord do thus to me and more as well, if even death parts me from you.
So, as best I can tell, marriage is something of a miracle. We humans are so independent, all of us, not just you, Chloe. We make our own decisions, we chart our own courses, and then sometimes we find another person. Because of some sort of miraculous love, we hitch our lives to theirs. In a world where contention so often seems stronger than community, marriage is a source of great hope. Not just for the two of you, but for all of us who witness it. So thank you for bringing all of us hope, especially in this Advent season when we are eager for it. For hope to be realized, though, or for love to be real, it doesn't have to be complicated. Chloe and Cody, when I asked you separately from one another how you knew this was the person for you, you each said, when I realized I wanted to do everything with them, not just the fun stuff, the boring everyday stuff too. Now, not everything is picture perfect. There are some spirited debates about how often is appropriate to burst out in song and about the proper way to fold a t-shirt. But love does not ask us to be perfect. It only asks us to be real. And what is really true is that the two of you have been so eager to join your lives together and to celebrate with these people who mean so much to you, but you kept asking me if there was any way to do it without having to stand up here in the front with every eye fixed upon you. And the best I could do was promise to keep it relatively short and promise that every single one of them is cheering you on. But the more we talked, the more I came to understand how much you really hate being the center of attention, and I couldn't help but think of a poem titled, To Be Famous. The river is famous to the fish. The loud voice is famous to silence, which knew it would inherit the earth before anybody said so. The cat sleeping on the fence is famous to the birds watching from the birdhouse. The tear is famous, briefly, to the cheek. The boot is famous to the earth, more famous than the dress shoe, which is famous only to floors. The bent photograph is famous to the one who carries it, and not at all famous to the one who is pictured. I want to be famous to shuffling men who smile while crossing the streets, and sticky children in grocery lines. I want to be famous as the one who smiled back. I want to be famous in the way a pulley is famous, or a buttonhole, not because it did anything spectacular, but because it never once forgot what it was made to do. Chloe and Cody, your discomfort of these eyes is surpassed only by your love for one another. So it is my hope and my prayer for you both that you will be famous, not to the world, but to one another. That you will be famous for one another. The way a pulley is famous or a buttonhole, not because it does anything spectacular, but because when you think about it, we actually live a tremendously diminished life without them. My people will be your people, Ruth says. Where you go, I will go, because I can't live without you, and I don't even want to try. You don't have to be famous to the whole world. You don't even have to be famous to this room. Be famous to one another. Be focused on one another. Never forget what you can be to one another and what you can be together. Remember that, and all the rest will follow, because we follow the one who is the source of all love, the one who has promised to see the two of you through all the days of your life. Amen. So Chloe and Cody, since it is your intention to marry, I invite you to join your hands together and with your promises bind yourselves together as husband and wife. Chloe, repeat after me. I, Chloe, take you, Cody, to be my husband. And I promise before God and these witnesses to be your loving and faithful wife. In plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Cody, repeat after me. I, Cody, take you, Chloe, to be my wife, and I promise before God and these witnesses to be your loving and faithful husband, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Well done. As we prepare to exchange rings, can I have them, please? The two of you have brought these rings as a visible sign of the promises you have just made to one another, a tangible gift that you give to one another in celebration today. Let us pray. By your blessing, O God, may these rings be to Chloe and Cody symbols of unending love and faithfulness, reminding them of the promise they make this day. Amen. Chloe, take Cody's ring. And repeat after me. Cody, I give you this ring as a sign of our abiding love. And with this ring, I thee wed. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Cody, take Chloe's ring Chloe, I give you this ring as a sign of our abiding love. And with this ring, I thee wed. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Once more, let us pray. God of all things joyful and true, we know that the reason we know how to love is because we have been loved by you. We are humbled by your gift of love that we see and celebrate today. And we pray now that you would surround Chloe and Cody with your grace, that they may fulfill the vows they have made. Provide for them, protect them, and support them as they undergo change in their lives. Grant them wisdom and devotion so that they may be to one another a strength in need, a counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. When they hurt or disappoint one another, give them grace to recognize their faults, courage to seek forgiveness, and mercy to extend it. Enable them to make their home a place of peace and welcome and joy. Make their life together a sign of your love for a weary world, and give them such fulfillment that they would be compelled to reach out with hope and concern for others. Grant that all of us who have witnessed these vows would leave here with our own commitments renewed and our own lives strengthened. Be with us, O God, as we celebrate together, for the love you have desired for all of your children has found a home in Chloe and Cody. Amen. Chloe and Cody, it is my privilege and my pleasure as a minister of Jesus Christ to celebrate that you are indeed husband and wife, and invite you now to share a kiss. We commit you both, even as we commit us all, to that greater love that never lets go. So friends, receive this blessing, every one of you. May the love of God surround you, the grace of Christ attend you, the Holy Spirit keep you, that you may live in faith, abound in hope, and grow in love today and forevermore. Amen. Now turn and look. Friends, it is my honor to present to you for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Cody and Chloe Griffith.